cover story, drawing a line in the stands.
WGN's Mike Lowe takes us inside Wrigley Field, where he caught up with a nationally renowned artist who is touring the country telling the story of baseball, all before the seventh inning sketch.
Unbelievable. It's beautiful.
From the marquee,
Peanuts,
to the mascot,
Ice Cold Water here,
and from the statues to the shirts.
That is vintage. Wow, 88.
There's so much to take in on a trip to Wrigley Field.
But I normally do a walk around the entire ballpark on the outside.
That it can take a little nudging.
Excuse me?
To remember the old saying, less is more.
Just taking things away until whatever's the essence filters up.
Self-taught artist S. Preston is trying to teach us that lesson.
I'm born in Canada, I'm Canadian, but I've been a lifelong Cubs fan forever.
With a sketch pad and an eye for the essential, he's making his way through the crowd to his seats at Wrigley Field.
I'm a minimalist graphic artist.
Where his prints are on display at the gift shop.
A lot of my ballpark artwork is all graphic arts.
He is one of only four professional artists licensed by Major League Baseball and is the only one licensed by the National Hockey League.
So it's graphical illustrations of mascots and stadiums around the league.
His images of all 30 stadiums are now in the Baseball Hall of Fame. He's done digital drawings of Soldier Field, the United Center, Sox Park, and Sister Jean. But there is something about his work, the way the subjects are instantly identifiable, yet use so few shapes and colors, that cuts through the clutter of the sights and sounds of the stadium.
So my ballpark art basically focuses on one part of every ballpark, one iconic aspect, whether it's noticeable by all fans or just the fans in that area, and zone into that point. And if you know it, you know it. And that's the fun part of minimalism.
The marquee would be too obvious, and so would the historic scoreboard. He found inspiration in the ivy.
There's the corner of the 365 sign in the corner with the brick and the ivy together, because those two together mean Wrigley Field. It can only mean Wrigley Field.
At his seat,
every ball game that I go to, I bring a sketchbook with me.
He's meticulously looking over what others might overlook. And in his trips across America's ballparks, he's noticed there's not a great way for dads and daughters to bond over baseball.
Some people overlook that the dads need to bring their daughters to the game and they need to do something that's fun for them.
So the renowned minimalist started drawing something different, something magical instead of minimal.
The characters that I normally draw are Disney princesses. I'm gonna be drawing Ariel here.
And over the course of a couple of innings, he'll draw a princess.
She'll be wearing a Cubs jersey. So I'll give her the pinstripes. Do you know who this is?
Ariel.
It's Ariel, yes. So now I'm just sort of putting in some colors. I've done over 250 giveaways now. I've been in 20-something ballparks, a bunch of minor league parks, and any stadium that I go to, I do this drawing for the local fan.
He takes a photo, then posts it on Twitter.
Section 220.
Along with his seat number. The first one to find him gets the picture for free.
I'm not rich, I'm an artist. So what I give back is my art.
In sketching a baseball princess.
Am I not here in time?
You're here in time.
Oh my God!
You made it.
He's also drawing new fans to the game he loves.
When you can kind of distill it down to just the ivy or just the yellow number.
Sandra Marchetti is now one of 250 people who have won the colorful contest.
Everybody knows what that means, and it just brings up that feeling, and the feeling is what's really beautiful and special.
And that's something to remember on the next trip to Wrigley.
Let's go, Cubby!
Yeah!
Among the avalanche of sights and sounds, characters and colors, the artwork of a minimalist has given fans so much more to see.
Gives them a good feeling, which is what art should do.
At Wrigley Field, Mike Lowe, WGN News.
We have a link to S. Preston's work and also a special web extra showing the process of how he drew Clark the Cub on a baseball, which, by the way, will be donated to charity.
And you might be surprised to find out why he prefers to draw mascots instead of players. And that's all on WGNTV.com.